Well, hello guys, and welcome again to a new video, and today we're going to talk a bit about everything that we are in. And if that sounds interesting, well, I suggest you should leave a like, comment and subscribe, because that helps out the channel quite a lot. And with that being said, let's actually get started. Link for the Discord, Telegram and everything in the description down below. If you want to join, make sure to do so. Looking at Anchor at the moment, Luna went down again in price, 34 bucks almost, yeah. Crashing down again, what you expect, like the same thing happening day after day after day. We go up, we go down, we go up and we go down. It's insane, the market. But in the long term, better say medium term, we should look at a healthy price of around 50 bucks for Luna. Still my best guess for the upcoming launch of Columbus 5. But yeah, you cannot really do much when the price is getting suppressed by whoever, you know. We cannot really tell for sure who's doing that. Of course, it's whales, but who? We don't know. For the anchor in rewards here, which would be around $111 at the moment. We got already staked 63 anchor, which is 233 bucks. Over on Apollo, Star Tower got delisted. I don't know why exactly. Withdraw only somehow. I don't know what happened there. As far as I am why is it not loading? Okay, sometimes, you know, stuff that's on tower doesn't work as it should work, but at the moment, yeah, it works again. Perfect. the farming, I don't know, has started, but yet to be seen. So I don't know when exactly that will happen, like the phase 2. Because yeah, at the moment the first already have been farmed. So yeah, I don't really know what is happening at the moment with Apollo. Like, the only thing I know is that I got a 25 in total so far farmed. So they might be doing this to wait until Columbus 5 is coming out. I don't know. Because most protocols and towers seem to be doing stuff like that. They just simply wait for Columbus 5 to come out and then they really start to put out something. Spectrum did drop as well as, yeah, if Luna drops, Spectrum is gonna drop as well. But we still farm here, 310% APY, which is actually not too bad at all. We have $4,289 worth of LP deposited, so our staked spec is 174 bucks. Also not too bad at all, and we also got something to talk about, which is actually very bullish for Olive again. Yes, Olive, our good old friend. You now could stake Olive over here on Grim Finance, and if you remember Grim Finance, well, they now added the vaults for Olive and Phantom as well as for Olive and USDC. So if you want to go over here, provide liquidity, you also could do it with Phantom alone. So that means you put in 50% Phantom and that gets split half and half to create yourself a liquidity token. And those would yield you 11.76%, and you don't need to do anything because that's basically automatic then afterwards. So what are we still doing? We also are still farming Morph and Phantom over here, but yeah, I don't know why it isn't showing. Here it is. It's showing up, and we got 1,350 bucks here at a percent of 9 per day. Well, the price of Morph seemed to been going down quite a lot in recent day. So yeah, $2.50, which is not looking too good at the moment. So yeah, I don't know. Really hard time to get, like, that's what I hate about this market. You cannot make any good predictions when it comes to farming, because the native token, which are not even like Morph and so like Phantom itself, if they drop, you're gonna see your native token drop as well. And that's one thing which is kind of bad. That's why I only farm with Wrapped ETH and Phantom at the moment. Even that bag is decreasing steadily, but still it is staying alive. You know, like in moments like this, it's good to farm with stuff like that. We also got new farms like the Reaper and Phantom. They really try to make the ecosystem evolve, as it seems like over here with all those farms, which I actually like. You know, like, it's hard to see stuff And that on Binance, of course, if you have some yield farms that work on top of each other, but most of them are simply not worth the risk. So I wouldn't really trusting most of them, but yeah, here on Phantom, I don't know, everything feels a bit different at the moment because those seem to be really putting in I'm not saying much, well, because I don't know all these farms, but so far it looks good that they are finally making the ecosystem a bit bigger in a certain way, because that's something that misses in a lot of places, like on different chains. And yeah, I would say I actually enjoy that a lot, that they are not going to do that. And yeah, I couldn't really be like, how to say it, I'm really happy like to see all these farms finally be on Grim Finance. Like being able to farm is simply something that's really good to see, because you don't need to do anything. And like I said from the beginning, auto compounding is stuff that's really good. And we also still farm Totem here with our olive that we put in, I don't know how many days ago, but yeah, since the start. And we now basically made the money back. So yeah, of course the value went down from them. I don't know when I bought them exactly at, but they are down basically. But yeah, Owen Phantom, you still got some good pools also at the moment, like the Olive and the USDC one and the Phantom one. So overall, I'm really bullish like for Phantom, but yeah, as I'm saying, the current market, I don't know, short term, I'm saying this month, like when we are over with this month, the price is going to start, how to say it, like it start to be a bit more normal again, like less pump and dumps, because at the moment it feels like every time we go up, we gonna dump afterwards. So really hard to do, and really hard to say like what's gonna happen with the market in general. That's like the one thing that I'm really concerned, is that manipulation is really ongoing and we don't know who are, like of course you can track the wallets, but you cannot really put a name behind someone if they never ever were on an exchange or whatsoever. Because one thing you can see that the volume is actually declining overall, like it started to pick up again at the peak and then slowed down, and somewhere here was a lot of buying, I think, and after now it's on the sideways a bit. So I'm thinking this could be very bullish actually for the whole market. I'm not saying that because yeah, I know the TA, but simply the fundamentals are pointing to a bullish future of Bitcoin, a bullish future of everything which has crypto. And yeah, that's like also for NFTs, we bought ourselves today some NFTs, I minted them. I got a few of them. I have 8 NFTs minted today, and 2 of them seem to be rare. And they're nothing special, like Bones Club. It's a collection I had back then already, like the Heritage Collection. But now they made another one, the Bones Club, and they have 10,000 bones. So I'm simply picking up some, as like picked some up at the minting. They are still able to be minted, but of course, I would wait maybe, with the collection, because there's not that much hype around them. But last time, they just went organically up in price. For me, what a smart idea would be, instead of trying to mint yourself some, is maybe looking for some that you like, really rare ones, trying to scope them up for a fair price on OpenSea maybe. That's something I would like to recommend instead of minting, because minting, no joke, in the end is just like gambling. Yeah, the diamond one so far exists a few. This one got sold for 0.125. Okay. He even listed them for 0.15, so he tripled his money and went away. Well, some strange people in here, because the whole NFT market in general is pushing up again. If we look at everything, most likely we're going to see some pushes. I think Fangs has even raised the floor price a bit, if I'm not mistaken. Oh yeah. Again, almost to 0.1 floor price, which is nice to see. Fangang was also a project I really enjoyed. But yeah, today, not much information, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Today is a bit of a calm day, because yeah, you cannot do much when the market is dumping on you all the time. So yeah, hope you enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Bye-bye.